First it was Bhaichung Bhutia's Humro Sikkim, and now it's a new regional party, Sikkim United Front. The Himalayan state of Sikkim is witness to launch of the two new parties in a short span of time. The newest entrant to the state's political arena, the Sikkim United Front, was officially launched in the state's Ranipool town today. Former Sikkim Minister Sonam Shering Bhutia hoisted the party flag in presence of a small bunch of supporters.
United Front Party
The party, already recognized by the Election Commission of India, has Narendra Adhikari as its president.
We are very sure that there are many political parties in Sikkim. But then also we don't find any young innovative ideas, young innovative thoughts which can make the prosperity and integrity of the society to a next level. We think that youth should come in front in order to reform the society and in order to make some political, administrative, judicial changes. So we think that I am not the leader of the party. I never will think that I am a leader of the party. But we have brought forth with a unique thought that we will run this party as an organizable based politics in which many thousands of people will be created as a leader who will be efficient, capable enough to show the new roads which will give Sikkim new heights.
The formation of two regional parties within a short span of time implies that the ruling Sikkim Democratic Front may not enjoy the kind of quote-unquote monopoly it enjoyed over the years during poll time. Add to that, the presence of the main opposition party Sikkim Krantikari Mocha, the opponents already look like a force. Even though the Sikkim United Front was official today, it has been critical of the incumbent Sikkim Democratic Front cabinet's policy on a number of issues. To add to it, the newly formed Humro Sikkim Party has launched an all-out attack on the government since the day of its formation. So what does it mean for the Pawan Chamling-led government in the state? Is the SDF slated to face stiff challenge this time?
जितने भी सारे लोग जितने भी पार्टी अभी गठन हो रहा है उन लोगों का अभी जो दर्शन जो नीति है जो एजेंडा है वो सभी पार्टी का एक ही जैसा है तो 2014 में देखिए SDF वर्सेस SKM पार्टी का देखने में तो वन टू वन एक फाइट हुआ था इलेक्शन में तो वो SKM पार्टी क्यों फिर भी सफल नहीं हो पाया इशू है सिक्किम में कि सिक्किम के जनता के बीच सिक्किम सब्जेक्ट वाले जितना भी सिवाई वाला जनता है सिक्किम का खाटी नागर के उन लोगों के बीच पॉलिटिकल राइट्स उन लोगों के बीच जमीन खरीद बिक्री करने का जो कानून है और उन लोगों के बीच धार्मिक जो अधिकार है वो इक्वालिटी और वो मतलब समानता के आधार पर है कि नहीं वो प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इक्वालिटी में है कि नहीं वो सबसे बड़ा इशू है
While Chamling has done well to launch a counter-attack on his prospective tough opponents in the run-up to the polls, the very presence of the rivals in the arena would mean that the longest-serving chief minister of the country will have to be on his toes.
It's a matter of time. Yes, we have to wait and watch. Because yes, since it's very tough, no doubt, like a party who has been running in the state of Sikkim for the last 25 years, it's not going to be easy. Neither is it going to be easy for the state government also. It's the STF government level is not going to be easy, I feel. Because a lot of young people are coming up. I see a lot of political parties that is coming up with very good issues. Now I can see the younger generation people doing politics, which is very beneficial for it. Now time is going to say like whether it's beneficial or not beneficial for the people of Sikkim.
All said and done. It is still too early in the day to comment on whether the almost unchallenged ruling party, hitherto, will be made to test its strength this time around. With camera person Binod Tamang, Sujal Pradhan reporting for Northeast Live from Sikkim.